In this video, we have a sort of cumulative review kind of problem. I have a bowling ball with a mass of 5 kilograms. It's being launched by a spring with constant 120 newtons per meter. The initial compression is 2.5 meters, and the angle of this spring gun is given to us. And so the first part of the problem is to figure out, if I launch this thing, how fast is the ball going when it flies out of the gun? And I'm going to refer to that as V0. And then the second part of the problem is, well, now that I know how fast it's launched out of the tip of this giant spring gun, how far is it going to go before it hits the ground? And that's a projectile motion problem. So the first part is approached with energy conservation. I have energy stored in the spring, but here's a warning in part A. You can't just ignore gravitational potential energy and pretend that the spring energy all goes into the speed of the ball, because the ball ends up higher than it was in its initial position. So that spring energy goes to two places. Part of it is the increase in gravitational potential energy. Part of it is the increase in kinetic energy. And I'm going to be clear about my coordinate system here. For the first part, I'm going to call y equals zero at the initial position of the ball. Then the final position of the ball when it pops out of this gun, that's going to be y final. And I need to find out how far up did it go during this process, because that's going to tell me how much of the energy went into the gravitational potential energy. And that's just given by a leg of a right triangle, where 2.5 meters, the compression distance, that's the hypotenuse. The angle here is 40 degrees, and 2.5 sine of 40 will give me that vertical change. And I'll go ahead and pop that right into the diagram. To 3 sig figs, that's 1.61 meters of increase in height during the launching process. So we write down our statement of energy conservation. E initial is equal to E final during the launch process. And the initial energy, because I put the origin of coordinates at the initial location of the ball, the y coordinate is zero, so the gravitational potential energy is zero. And there's certainly no kinetic energy in the initial state, so the only energy in the initial state is the potential energy stored in the spring. And then in the final state, when the ball pops out of the gun, I have some gravitational potential energy and I have some kinetic energy. So we plug in the expressions for all these things, and my initial spring potential energy is 1/2 kx². I'll call it x initial for the initial compression. My final gravitational potential energy is going to be an mgy final, and my final kinetic energy is going to be a 1/2 mv². And I'm going to call that V0, because that's the launch velocity we're going to use for part B. So we just plug in all the numbers. K was 120 newtons per meter. The initial compression was 2.5 meters. The mass of the bowling ball is 5 kilograms. G is 9.8. My final Y coordinate when the launch is complete, that's 1.61 meters. And again, M is 5 kilograms. And my only unknown there is the speed at the end of the launch process. So I prefer to do calculations like this just all at once in my calculator. So I'm going to smash these numbers together on the left, and then I'm going to subtract the product of all these numbers, then multiply the result by 2, divide by 5, and square root the result, and we've got V0. And I get a launch velocity of 10.88 meters per second, and to 3 sig figs, that's 10.9 meters per second. Okay, so that's part A. And then in part B, I want to compute the range of the ball. And this is just a classic projectile motion problem. I have a launch velocity that's known. I'll go ahead and call it 10.88 meters per second, so I don't compound the rounding error more than necessary. I know the initial launch height that's given in the diagram. That's an initial height of 2 meters. And I want to get the range. How far does it go horizontally before it hits the ground? And so the standard approach to this is to decompose that initial velocity vector into components. And the horizontal one I'll call V0x. And just a reminder, this angle here is still 40 degrees. So V0x is 10.88 cosine of 40. And that's about 8.33 meters per second. Then V0y is going to be a 10.88 sine of 40. And this gives me about 6.99 meters per second. Then what we know in the final state of the projectile, so it hits the ground right here, what we know is the final y coordinate. The final y coordinate is zero. So we're going to use a y analysis first, and we're going to use that to find the flight time. So we write down our first constant acceleration kinematics formula. The vertical acceleration here is negative g, so I'll go ahead and plug that in. And the final y position is zero. The initial y position was 2 meters. Initial y velocity was 6.99. I don't know the flight time. Half of g is 4.9 if we use 9.8 for g. So I have a minus 4.9 t squared on there. And we have a non-trivial quadratic equation to solve, so we're going to use the quadratic formula for this. I prefer to have a positive leading coefficient on that, so I'm going to add all the terms to the left side. Equivalently, you could say I'm just multiplying all this by negative 1. And you can either plug this into a piece of technology, or we can go ahead and apply the quadratic formula. I'll go ahead and show the long way. So t is going to be negative b plus or minus the square root b squared minus 4 times a times c, and there's a double negative in there to be careful with, and then divided by 2a, which is 9.8. And when I simplify the square root piece, I get a 9.38 for that. And I can immediately tell I'm going to get one positive value of t and one negative value, and we discard the negative value. So the negative value will happen from subtracting the 9.38. I'm only going to keep the one where I add 9.38. And this gives me a flight time of 1.67 seconds. Next, we go to the equation that describes the horizontal position as a function of time. So x is equal to x naught plus v naught xt. And in general, you'd have a plus 1/2 x acceleration times t squared. But we know for projectile motion, the x acceleration vanishes. This also means the initial x velocity is just equal to the final x velocity. It's just a constant velocity in the x direction. By assumption here, we're going to put our initial position at 0, and then the final position will be the range. So we plug in our initial x velocity, and that was 8.33 meters per second. We multiply it by how long it was moving that fast before it hit the ground. That was 1.67 seconds, and it turns out the range of this bowling ball is 13.9 meters. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.